I'm here in Howick in Northumberland in England. I'm at Howick House, which is a archaeological site, a Mesolithic house. And if you can see the nettles here, that's where the house was. You can see the entranceway there. And this is used
7,600
years BC and is one of the oldest known occupied sites in the United Kingdom. And Mesolithic cultures tended to be hunter-gatherers. And so they tended to occur alongside fresh water and especially alongside the coast, including the area called the Dogger Bank. So out there at this time, there was an area of swampy vegetation, of pools, of dry land, of woods, where there's a very healthy Mesolithic culture. And then in 6,200 BC, a vast area of rock slipped off the southwest Norwegian coast called the Storegga Slide. And this resulted in a huge tsunami, a wave that came past Shetland going at 100 kilometers an hour, and it was 30 meters high there. And then it came into the North Sea, hit the coast, Scotland and Northumberland, 3 to 6 meters high, and seems to have had a devastating effect on the Dogger Bank. And archaeologists have looked in the Howick and Doug's cores and found evidence of sediment resulting from this tsunami. In fact, it's even been found 80 kilometers inland. So this seems to have had a devastating ecological and humanitarian impact. What are the broad consequences of these rare events? Russ Landy studied the theory of this, and he showed that if you look at what's called demographic stochasticity, that's the fact that some generations, it might be, say, all individuals are male or all individuals are female, or those sorts of demographic effects, that can cause extinctions, but only in really small populations. He then looked at environmental stochasticity, that in some years, it might be there's a cold winter resulting in high mortality, or dry summer resulting in a low birth rate. And that could have serious impacts, including extinction on small populations. And then he looked at catastrophes, these widespread population impacts, and showed that these could have an impact both in pushing small populations over the edge so they go extinct, but also could sometimes take medium-sized populations and push them towards extinction. So the odd effect, the odd rare effect, can have serious consequences. The Mesolithic cultures seem to have had been really pushed back by the Storegga Slide. So the numbers seem to have crashed soon afterwards. And it seems likely that whenever there's an ecological catastrophe, there'll also be devastating humanitarian consequences at the same time, as seem to have happened in this case here. So what the lessons are that rare catastrophic events can have serious ecological consequences, as well as the serious humanitarian consequences for the cultures involved.